Hey guys, it's me Minori and my pet Baymax. Welcome back to my channel. Hi. So before anything, please let me explain. I am not going to do this on a human today. No human will be hurt. I see tattoo as an art. And as an artist, I just wanted to try out new mediums to see if I like it or not. Because you won't know if you like it or not unless you try it out. But please, please let me make this very clear. Do not do tattoos at home. Please go to a store and get it professionally done, and this is not a DIY tattoo tutorial. So with that out of the way, yo, what's up? I'm going to try tattooing today. You can actually buy these tattoo machines at Amazon for like $20, which kind of makes me scared. But I'm going to be using this machine and some fake skin to test it out today. And as always, I want to test it out with my style, which is manga anime style. And since I know Ariana Grande has a lot of anime tattoos all over her, like I know she has Eevee and Sen from Spirited Away. So I think I'm going to try recreating those today. I honestly don't know how it's going to turn out. I just want to have fun and I hope you guys like this video. So without further ado, recreating Ariana Grande's anime tattoos. Let's get started. Okay, so here are all the stuff that you need. Okay, I am not a professional. I'm not really sure about the process and everything, but I did look up some YouTube videos and I'm just going to try to recreate it as much as possible. So here we go. Some fake skin, carbon sheets, stencil gel, little cups for the ink, some ink, and the machine with some real needles. I'm going to get the gun, plug it in inside this machine, and I guess all I have to do now is to plug it and step on this foot pedal when I want to use it. So I'm kind of scared. Again, this is just for fun, and since we have everything ready, let's start tattooing. So this is how the gun looks like. I have played with this tattoo kit before once, but only once before in my life, but I'm still so amused with how it looks like because it's not something that I get to see and hold every single day. And like I said, there's a foot pedal, and when I step onto it, oh wow. I mean, can you even see the needle moving? You can also change the settings to change the speed, and to be honest, it's so scary, but I still want to do this video, so let's move on. And here I have a bowl of ham, and inside there's some soap water. So while I'm a complete noob with tattoos, I did look up and educate myself for a good few weeks to learn about the right materials, the right procedures, and apparently a lot of people recommend using this Dr. Bronner's magic soap to clean up the surface. So I've got that ready, and next I need to pour some ink into the small cup. So I did buy this kit and it came with this black ink, but I don't know what I did with it. I couldn't find it. So I'm just going to go with purple ink today. Now that we have everything ready, I'm just going to dip into the ink and let's start tattooing. That was intense. It feels kind of satisfying how the needle goes smoothly into the rubber surface. I don't know how to describe it. And then I'm going to get some soap water and rub off the excess ink. So the line is there. It's not bad, but I think it kind of looks a bit sheer. Like the end of the line looks so much more thick and rich compared to the beginning. It's really hard to make a steady line. You press in too hard, the needle will get stuck into that one point and stops moving, and if you press in too lightly, then all it leaves is a small scratch. Making it steady and bold and straight all at the same time is quite challenging. And I mean, this is just like synthetic skin, but if this were a real human, you don't get too many chances to do one line. You need to be confident and make bold straight lines to make a nice tattoo. And this is hard. I went on making a lot of lines for practice, and then when I felt a bit more comfortable, I decided to draw a flower. I thought a flower is like a common tattoo, and I wanted to try drawing something that wouldn't be too complicated. I wanted to practice a bit more before going into recreating some more anime tattoos, and not going to lie, I felt pretty confident that I even started shading it a bit. As someone who has no clue about tattoos, not bad, I think. I mean, I'm not even using a stencil, just a freehand random drawing, so I don't think it's that bad. But I got some soap water and washed it off, only to reveal a very light drawing. I guess I have a lot to work on to make consistent bold lines. Now on to the fun part. Let's start making anime tattoos. And like I said, I wanted to recreate Ariana Grande's tattoos. And she has Eevee on her left, I think left, top part of her left arm. So what I'm gonna do is outline the size of the tattoo sheet, and first off, I'm going to draw Eevee on a paper. I want to make a stencil first, and obviously if you're getting a real tattoo, I would advise you to use the real drawing and copy that rather than starting from scratch. But today I don't have all the materials, so I'm just going to be drawing it from scratch. Now that I've drawn Eevee with a pencil, I outlined it with a pen just so I get a clearer line and it will be easier for me to see. Next, I'm going to use some carbon sheets. This was my first time using these sheets, and this one is specifically for tattoo arts. Like, it says tattoo carbon sheets. And if you look here, it says you can print out a drawing and then transfer it over using a transfer copier. I looked it up and apparently costs around like $175. I ain't going to buy a random new machine. That's why I decided to hand draw it. And it says that you can also just use a pencil to trace over it to make a stencil. So that is what I'm going to do today. You basically need to like scratch pretty hard so the ink gets picked up onto the first layer. At first try, it looked like it worked, so I got my drawing and using a pen, I traced over it quite hard. And then when I flipped it over, nothing? Okay, what did I do wrong? I thought maybe I needed to press in harder, so I got a pencil and went in a lot harder than before. Like, I was pressing in hard that my hand was starting to hurt, or maybe I'm just weak. But again, nothing. Then I noticed that there's a protective sheet in between the layers that I need to get rid of. Oh, I see. Okay. Like, girl, just read the instructions. Spoiler alert, I never do. Okay, so I went in again. Just to reveal nothing, I came into conclusion that my hand was too weak to go through, so I got rid of my first drawing and decided to draw right on top of the sheet, just so there will be extra pressure onto it. And at last, it finally kinda worked. Like, it's not perfect, but it's just a stencil. All I need is like some lines for me to help, and I thought this was enough. After so many mistakes, I finally moved on to the next stage. So, you need something called stencil gel to transfer the stencil onto the skin. I also looked up online for this and got the most recommended product. Wait, why is it not coming out? Oh, there's the protective seal. It says that a little goes a long way. Oh, that was a little bit too much. And I'm just spreading it with tissue. And the instructions, hey, look, I actually read the instructions. It said that it needs to be tacky and not wet. So when it felt like it was the right time, I placed on the stencil, rubbed it gently, and removed it. After you remove the sheet, you apparently need to wait for a few minutes for it to completely dry. And the reveal. I mean, the stencil itself was really light, so yes, it's not perfect, but I think it was enough for me to move on to do the tattooing. So hold in your breath and let's just jump right in. By the way, I decided to use black ink that I had for my comic drawings. Okay, obviously, do not use comic ink for real tattoos. Like, I don't know if I can stress it enough that this video is really just for fun. No harm, I'm just trying out new things without hurting anyone. And since I knew I was just using synthetic skin and I couldn't find the black ink that it came with, I thought I could just use my normal ink as a substitute. It actually did not work well, which I'm going to show you later on. I thought that my first drawing came out really light because of the ink. You know how I was just using purple ink? So I wanted to see how it would look like with darker ink. Oh no, a smudge. And to be honest, it looks so much better. The lines look very thick and juicy. So I've never really drawn with tattoo machines before, but to be honest, it's kind of similar to my manga supplies. I also use these dip-in pens and ink to draw mangas, and the way the pen works is kind of similar that I was starting to get the hang of it. Not bad. I was becoming more and more confident until this happened. Can you guys see that tick? I made this random horizontal line in the middle of the tail. And I just went onto the rest of the body and the eyes. I say this in like every video, but eyes are my favorite part. I love drawing it and I love watching it getting filled. So here's a close-up views of the eyes. I don't have much tip or technique. I mean, I'm a noob. I made more quick strokes on the bottom half to make like a more lighter shadow. Now that the drawing is mostly complete, I added in some shadows here and there to make it a little bit more extra. And this is how it turned out. And our drawing is complete. What do you guys think? I was actually quite happy with it, but then I tried to go and wash off the excess, and then realized that the ink wasn't really coming off. It kind of got all smudged. It was because obviously this ink was not for tattooing. Okay, so now that my Eevee is complete, I decided to move on to... Oh my gosh, you guys cannot believe this, but I bought this. Let's try opening it. Like when you first saw my thumbnail, I think you saw like a hand, but I am not clickbaiting you. Well, kinda, but this is a synthetic hand for practicing tattoos.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
It's a silicone hand. Oh my gosh, this is a pretty big hand compared to my hand. But again, my hand is so small. Oh my god, this is so awkward. It's so stretchy and like gummy. And it looks exactly like a real hand. Like you can even see the lines.
Let me massage. Okay, let's just say his name is Ken. I'm going to be tattooing Ken today. There's actually body parts sold specifically for practicing tattoos. It's not that expensive too. It's like, I think you can get them for like less than $10. So fret not, it is made for tattoos and I'm just using this for recreating another anime tattoo Ariana has and it is Sen from Spirited Away. My favorite Ghibli movie ever. Nice choice, Ari. Nice choice. Again, I'm just going to hand draw this onto the carbon sheet. I'm just repeating the process from Eevee, just drawing and scratching the surface really hard so the ink gets transferred over to the first layer. Okay, Ken, are you ready? Putting on some gel and stencil and... Oh, again, let me explain that normally if you're actually tattooing someone, I would recommend using gloves for sanitary purposes. But Ken is just fine. And I tried to put the stencil on, but because it's so curved, it was hard to get the paper straight on. So when I took it off, parts of the lines didn't really get transferred onto the hand. I mean, Ken wasn't really cooperating with me as well. But anyways, I decided to redraw it and make another stencil and redo it. This time worked okay. Again, not perfect, but I think it was enough for me to work on. So I decided to go with it. So again, guys, hold in your breath and let's get started. I've said this in my other videos before, while I love every Ghibli movie, Spirited Away is definitely my favorite. No debate, with a lot of second places. But if I were to choose one... So hard, but I think Kiki's Delivery Service is kinda underrated because I love that movie so much. Right off the bat, it feels so different with the synthetic skin. Like, this one was a bit more hard to press in. It was like softer? Like, I guess because it's more similar to human skin, it was kind of bumpy. Like, you know how skins aren't really smooth? You can just look at your own hand, but your hand has a lot of bones and blood vessels. They kind of pop out, so you don't really have a flat surface. I also decided to go back to purple ink because I didn't want to mess this one up like last time with all the smudges. So I'm just staying here with the original tattoo ink. Honestly, my hand was kind of hurting at this point. The pen itself is quite heavy and it's vibrating the whole time, so it's kind of hard to control it. But I do think I am improving, but I think this tattoo overall turned out not that great. I don't think Sen looks too good. Like, she looks like Haku and Sen fused in together. She kind of looks mad. And to be honest, I would not want this on my skin forever. Moral of the story, guys, please get a professional if you ever do want a tattoo on yourself. But if you're someone who's never had a tattoo before, and if you're looking for a cheap way to get one, don't do this, or I really don't recommend it. However, if you want to do it for fun, just like me, then I'm all for it. I ended this tattoo by shading the hair in, which I kinda regretted later, but I just wanted to have fun and do a bit more extra stuff to kinda play around with it. And after a very long day and lots of messing up, here is how it turned out.
So moral of the story? Don't do it at home, guys. I mean, I think I'm kind of experienced with drawings and anime drawings in general, but it still turned out quite bad. But as a project, I had a lot of fun. And shout out to all the tattoo artists who make really great art using these supplies, because these aren't that easy to use. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next video. Bye!